In New Zealand, we have a potential for very large earthquakes. This computer simulation shows ground shaking or ground velocities during a potential magnitude 8.4 earthquake on the plate boundary fault beneath the North Island of New Zealand. Approximately 2,000 times more energy would be released than during the damaging magnitude 6.2 Christchurch earthquake in 2011. In this scenario, the segment of the plate boundary fault that ruptures is at 5 to 40 kilometers depth and is shown in the rectangle. The earthquake rupture starts on the plate boundary fault, about 16 kilometers beneath Waipukarau. It then moves towards Wellington. Many other towns and rural communities would also be affected by a quake of this magnitude. You can see that the model is running in real time. The ground shaking is most intense towards the south, as this is the direction of fault rupture in this particular simulation. Red indicates severe ground shaking, with the highest level shown in yellow. The ground shaking, or peak ground velocity, in this scenario is comparable to that felt during the 6.2 February 2011 quake in Christchurch, but lasts much longer, 1 or 2 minutes, rather than 10 seconds. Severe shaking reaches Wellington about a minute after the start of the earthquake. The earthquake rupture terminates just south of Wellington in Cook Strait. The shaking continues across the North Island and now also the South Island. Geological and geodetic records suggest that an earthquake of this size can occur, on average, every 500 to 1,000 years in the lower North Island. The shaking would be felt severely throughout the lower half of the North Island and the upper South Island. Such an earthquake would cause extensive damage to New Zealand. Very approximate losses can also be modeled. If the earthquake happened in daytime, the estimates are in the range of 30 fatalities, 900 injuries, and $10 billion of direct losses to buildings. But this estimation of losses does not include those from subsequent events, such as fires, floods, or tsunami. Under this scenario, tsunami would be generated due to displacement of the seafloor. Here is a computer model of the tsunami, which will show initially at times 11 speed. In the first 2 minutes, the sea level rise is associated with the displacement of the seafloor during the earthquake rupture. Then, the tsunami waves begin to spread in all directions. The scale bar does not show the maximum tsunami height, which would be between 5 and 7 meters along the Wairarapa coast. Note how quickly the tsunami travels. Within 7 minutes after the initial shaking, the tsunami has already reached parts of the coast. There would be no time for an official tsunami evacuation warning. Finally, we will speed up our model again to show how the tsunami spreads along the coast in the first hour following the earthquake. The strength and duration of earthquake shaking would be the signal to immediately self-evacuate all tsunami hazard zones, that is, low-lying land in coastal areas.